Hi everyone, welcome to part three. And we want to get to the bottom of some things in this episode, like their alibis and some clues. We're at the police station there. We want to ask about hair at the barber's, because we went into the house and got it. So does it match what you found at the crime scene? No, it doesn't match Cassandra's hair. Wow. Not surprised, to be honest. Next, we want to go and check...
a letter.
The other place.
A banker could use it.
Or the other alibi. We managed to find Cassandra's alibi. Again, Cassandra doesn't match. No, it doesn't match.
So it doesn't. The two pieces of evidence do not match. Either of their... It's annoying. We're not able to find out. Right, we need to go back to Rosberg. Rocksmith. Ask about a suspect. Quick, go. Shit, we wasted some money.
Oh well. So, you know, it looks to me like both of these people are innocent. And there's this one other suspect that was mentioned. Obviously, we're not able to get access to him within this game, in this episode, unfortunately.
Oh, no more. Usually there's a lot more suspects. This is really shit.
Yeah, so the alibis, Cassandra's alibi. Oh, Cassandra's alibi was wrong there. Oh, yeah, Cassandra's alibi was wrong. She wasn't at the place that she said. So I suspected her. Well, I'll see you for the part four where we uncover who the murderer is, basically, and whether I got it right or wrong as well, we find out. Yeah. I mean, if I get it wrong, you can't really blame me, to be honest, not making excuses, but there's literally two suspects, and I have to look at it logically. The evidence is all against Cassandra, and there's not one bit of evidence against the other guy, Craig. So, yeah.